After winning the Davis Cup for Great Britain and closing out the year as world number two, Andy Murray is finding his footing on court. For his last match of the season, Murray agreed to play tie-break tens alongside John McEnroe, Tim Henman, and British newcomer Kyle Edmund. Each match in the quickfire tournament lasts around 10 minutes. Players compete in the round-robin style format and try to be the first to score 10 points. The winner receives $250,000.
As soon as I heard the idea, I just thought it was incredible. It had synergies to other sports where shorter formats have worked so well. The important thing is the game can change very quickly. A few points can make a big difference.
An icon of the game, a former world number one, it's John McEnroe.
This is unpredictable, and that's what I think people are looking for.
Former Wimbledon, US Open, current Olympic and Davis Cup winner, Andy Murray.
The crowd seem to enjoy it. They get to see a lot of different matchups. You see all of the players playing. And for me personally, it's also nice to watch, you know, be on the court with John and Tim. You know, these are guys I obviously look up to.
The final came down to a showdown between big serving Kyle Edmund and his Davis Cup teammate, Andy Murray. In the end, it was Edmund's bullet serve that proved a little too much for Murray, the 20-year-old claiming the biggest check of his life.
In this event, for example, Kyle Edmund showed me something. I sort of knew what he was capable of, but I was pleasantly surprised to see that he's made some really good progress. And if he continues to make that progress, and you see three, four other guys push each other, that to me should be inspirational.
A couple of predictions for next year.
Stan's made a believer of some of the older guys because he rose to the occasion big time with the Friends. So I would assume that the 28, 30 something guys feel like they have a shot.
Federer at 34 is still playing as well as ever. You've got Djokovic, you've got Murray, Nadal. So we've got to enjoy them while we can because they're not going to be around forever, but they've had a huge impact in the game.
What sort of rules would you be looking at to change, to spice it up?
Top two rule changes for me next year. No warm-up, no linesman. Give that some thought.
The lines people and warm-ups will still be in place in Melbourne as Andy Murray chases his third Grand Slam crown. He'd like nothing more than to start 2016 off on a winning note before he takes some time off for family business.
And you've got a big surprise coming in just after the Australian Open.
Yeah, in February, wife gives birth, so it'll be the first child, and yeah, very excited about that. It'll be a big change. Yeah, don't quite know what to expect, but yeah.
We never do as new parents.
I know, I look forward to it though.
Thanks very much, mate.
Thanks,
cheers.
Mate.